If you wanted an ID card, you had to sign up either as a Muslim, a Christian, or a Jew, and there was no other religion that would qualify for an identification card. We fought the case in the courts and lost twice, and then finally prevailed, and the courts upheld the right to Baha'is to be able to write other and then get their identification card. And this also helped the Coptic Christians and some other minorities, and atheists for that matter, who up until that point could not get an identification card unless they had put one of the religions that was stipulated. So, but we found in the case of Egypt that civil society, Egyptian civil society, stood up and said, Baha'is are Egyptians, we are Egyptians, they are our brothers and sisters, and therefore, we have to. So there were daily demonstrations outside the courtroom by both the right-wing fundamentalists that didn't want any Baha'is in the country, but also by this civil society, the moderate men and women of Egypt that stood up and spoke out for Baha'is, and I'm sure that had something to do with it. So the reason why I'm making this point is that I think you should be engaging civil society within any of the countries where Sikhs are being denied their rights, and engaging civil society within the country to call for, you know, the country to take the moral high ground of granting every one of its citizens their rights. Again, the Canadian example was a very good one, and it was shared earlier. I know that the Sikhs in UK have also had some success in being able to demonstrate their rights and their right to wear the turban, and that of their identity in other aspects as well. And so I think it would be very helpful if there were diplomatic efforts made on the part of Sikh representatives in those countries, calling for the government to assist their co-religionists in France and anywhere else that there may be a problem. And I'm sure we can explore more in the discussion. Thank you.